Whenever this gospel comes up, I immediately think of one person, Charlie Lau. My apologies to Cub fans who are here, because Charlie Lau was for many years the batting instructor for the Chicago White Sox, and he was regarded as the best batting instructor ever in the history of the major leagues. However, when he played in the major leagues, he didn't hit 400, he didn't hit 350, he didn't hit 300, he didn't hit 275, he hit 255 lifetime. He knew what to do, he knew how to bat, but he just couldn't do it. Don't know why, maybe he didn't have the eye-hand coordination, maybe he didn't practice enough, who knows. He knew what to do, however, and just couldn't do it himself. Well, Jesus says that today about the Pharisees. Observe what they tell you, but don't follow their example. They are like the Charlie Lau of Jesus' day. But when you think about that, welcome to being human. We ourselves, as Christian people, do we know what we're supposed to do to be disciples of the Lord? Absolutely. It's immediately available to us. Be patient, be loving, be kind. Do unto others as we would have them do unto us. And yet still, we're not in 400. We're just not. And I'll start with myself first. So St. Therese of Lisieux said, "We are condemned to forever fall short of where we wish to be." St. Paul says, "I do the things I shouldn't do, and I don't do the things I should." Well, why does Jesus attack the Pharisees and Sadducees then, and not everybody? Well, the problem with the Pharisees and the Sadducees, they thought that they had everything down pat. This Judaism thing, no problem. We have it down pat, no problem at all. We do everything correctly. So much so that we're going to tell you how to do everything correctly. Well, of course, Jesus goes after them and says, this is a lifetime of work. This isn't something that we have down pat. Putting God's life in our life is a task for a lifetime. The Pharisees and the Sadducees were picking on everybody except for themselves, and they were proud also of their title and of their clothes. And that doesn't change too much. I remember a number of years ago, Cardinal George wanted to name Monsignors in the Archdiocese of Chicago. And one classmate of mine actually was considered to be a Monsignor. And so the Cardinal called him up and said, I want to make you a Monsignor. And my apologies to the people who are under 18 here. But he asked, what the hell does that mean? Imagine saying that to the boss. Pretty amazing. But then there were other priests who got the call, and they had their Monsignor outfits already measured and ready to go. Sometimes we can get focused on the wrong things, and that's really what Jesus is taking everyone to task for. We don't want to focus on the wrong things. We want to focus on being disciples, on being the people that the Lord wants us to be. And so it's no coincidence then that this reading comes just a few days after All Saints Day. For the saints, their life and Jesus' life were one. St. Paul says, Christ lives in me. And that indeed is the task of all Christian people all over the world for all time. We want to be certainly the saints that Jesus calls us to be. Well, that means then getting Jesus' life into our own, getting his life and our life in sync. And that is not a task for a day or a month or a year, but truly we spend our entire life trying to do that. A life of work, a life of prayer, a life of humility. But inevitably what will happen? We won't hit 400. We are going to fall short of that goal. And so the prayer for us today is very simple. Lord, when we fall short, help us to put your life in ours.